From the guys at Shiftline in Russia. Hello, Oleg and company. I hope you are all well. This is the Twin Mark IIIs from Shiftline. It is a tube preamplifier in a very fine aluminium one-piece case with a little tube inside it as well, doing all the heat work. And it is a fabulous preamp that emulates the sound of a classic twin. You've got a balanced out, you've got auxiliary in, you've got headphone output, you've got a Thru output if you want to send it to something else, you know, bypass the thing entirely and send your signal to another amp as well. You've got effects, send and return, and in fact today I have a Specular Tempus hooked up to it, which is from GFI Systems for a little bit of reverb and delay. And you've got a micro SD card slot as well, so you can actually insert two of your own impulse responses. They are the cabinet simulations, but it comes with two great ones, so I feel zero need to actually do that. This is a Fender Telecaster Hot Rod 52, and I'm running directly from the Twin into my Presonus Quantum. So let's have a listen, first of all, with these controls dialed at noon on cabinet A, the description of which is on the bottom of your screen. The volume controls the balanced output volume here. This master volume controls the other output volume. You've got an unbalanced out if you want to use it as well, and that's what the master control is for. So like a good twin of the real world, that bass can get pretty flubby if you turn it up. So don't, keep it back a little bit. You can clean it right up with the gain control. Or you can absolutely crank it with the gain control. Getting into Keith territory there, this little tops toggle switch will either add tops if you've shifted up to the plus sign, or it will subtract if you wish to tame them a little bit. In the middle, it doesn't do anything. You've got a ground switch here as well if you're experiencing some hum. And then, of course, there's the cabinet switch here. So that was cabinet A. If I go down to cabinet B, which is on the bottom of your screen also telling you what it is, that's my favourite cabinet. There's something cool about it. But you can bypass it, so you can use it just as a preamp and run it into the speaker cabinet simulation or real-world speakers of your choice. I'm going to leave it on the B cabinet, and I'm going to turn our Specular Tempus on so we can hear what that effects loop does. Bit of delay and reverb there. And I'm also going to introduce an overdrive pedal. In this case, it's the Blues Pro Overdrive from MI Audio, because I know that you guys want to hear what it sounds like with pedals. Here it is, all controls at noon. These passive tone controls are very subtle. I like them a lot. Now, if we crank the gain, that overdrive is going to be even more pronounced. I'll keep it at midday and we'll go to the other cabinet and have a listen to the difference. Big difference, much more scooped mid-range. So back to the first cabinet, or the second cabinet actually. Back to the beautiful clean sound. So you could use this as you know, you can feed front of house with it. You can use the other output to feed a power amp and a speaker cabinet if you wanted to. You could use a Thru output to send it to a second amplifier. You've got balanced out for Mr. Front of House guy, auxiliary in if you want to play some music through it or something like that. Headphone output if you want to sit it in the privacy of your bedroom or lounge room and not disturb anybody else. It's really thorough. In terms of this gain control, the sweet spot to me seems to be up around 12, 1 o'clock with a single coil guitar like this. Reverb back on. But because you can get that kind of Keef sound with the gain cranked, that's good. First cabinet again. I don't think that one sounds as good for the overdrive sound, but it's really good for that glassy kind of silver face twin sound. I like this one. So there it is. It is built immaculately, as you would expect from the guys at Shiftline, because all of their stuff is amazing, and it's a significant improvement on the Mark II, which is also good, but this is a beautiful case. It sounds great. There's nothing that's wanting as far as ins and outs and facilities goes. It gives you a perfect sort of black face and silver face twin tone. You can load your own IRs in there if you want to. Good stuff.